All right. So your day might be feeling very formless and very stressful. You probably start your day with your phone right by your side, and you wake up and you're like, okay, I'm awake. Let me see what people are up to. Let me see what's happening in the world. So you grab your phone and you open up an app, whether that's Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, or a news outlet. You open it up and you see like, what's happening in the world? I have this question. I need it answered. And you walk to the bathroom and you have your phone and you're going to the bathroom and you're like, scroll, scroll, scroll. And next thing you know, it's been like 15 minutes. You're like, oh shoot, like I should be doing the thing. I need to go do the thing, right? And then maybe you turn the television on. You know, okay, cool. I got some information from my phone. Now I need to get it from my local news or the national news. And I need to be informed about what's happening so that I can be an informed citizen, right? But the next thing you know, it's like 2 hours of media consumption and you haven't done anything yet. You haven't accomplished anything yet. You don't feel good about your day. You've just been like, consuming media, consuming information about what's happening in the world, but you haven't actually created the life that you want. So this continues day to day, and it also just continues like throughout your day, checking your phone. Is there new updates? What's there? What's going on? So I wanna give you some statistics. If you consume 2 hours of social media in a day, that comes out to 60 hours a day, right? So like 2 times 30 is 60. Divide that by 24 hours in a day, that is 2.5 days of media consumption if you're consuming 2 hours a day, okay? If you're also consuming 2 hours of television, so like 2 hours of social media, 2 hours of television, that comes out to 4 hours a day or 5 full days of your month, right? A lot of consumption. If you've been doing this the last 4 months, that's 20 full days of the time that we've been at home of just consuming information. And we know the truth is nothing has changed. Like what we're supposed to be doing, nothing has changed. We're supposed to be staying home. We're supposed to be social distancing if we do go out. We're supposed to be wearing a mask. We're supposed to be washing hands. Those basic things have not changed. What you are responsible for has not changed, right? You think that consuming and finding out all of the little things that are changing is going to help calm your anxiety. It's going to help calm the questions that you have about what's happening in the world. But the truth is, all of this consumption is actually paralyzing you. It's paralyzing you from creating the life that you want, even while you're at home during a pandemic. It's paralyzing you, and your day just kind of feels gross. You feel gross. You're probably not getting enough sleep. You're reaching for sugar and caffeine. You're feeling really irritated by your kids. You're not waking up on time. You're not getting to bed on time. It just kind of snowballs, right? And so this probably happens where you're like, man, I feel like crap. Maybe I need to do keto to get myself in shape again. Maybe I need to go back to Whole30. That worked that last time. You know, I went overboard allowing myself to consume sugar. I need to do a Whole30 to clear myself out. Or maybe you're like, oh, I need to download this 30-day boot camp workout plan at home because I need to go from being neglectful to being super authoritarian to get myself out of this mess. What I want to suggest is something different. Instead of jumping from neglectful up to authoritarian, there's something else that you can do. Because we know what happens. You jump from neglectful to authoritarian, you swing over to permissive and back to neglectful. And you kind of do this triangle where you are being super strict and then like, oh man, I've been so strict. I need to let up a little bit. And then letting up a little bit turns into letting up a lot of it. And then you're like, let me be super strict again to get myself out of this mess. So instead of constantly going through this triangle of things with diet and with exercise, I want to propose something different, completely different than anything else that you've tried before. And I'm going to teach you these three questions to help you get yourself out of this triangle. And I want to tell you about one of my clients. So Jessica came to me because she was struggling. She wanted to lose weight. She's tried doing so many different diet plans. She's tried the 21-day fix containers. She tried using Noom. She's tried, I mean, Noom is basically counting calories. She's tried all of those things when it comes to food, right? So like, she's like, oh man, why can't I get this? It's so simple. But the truth is her mornings felt The mornings felt really chaotic. Her mornings felt chaotic. She was waking up late, consuming a lot of social media, feeling really gross, feeling really guilty. And then this self-loathing talk started. And then it was like, why can't you do anything right? Why can't you get this together? What's wrong with you? So those are the three questions that are going over her head over and over. What's wrong with you? Why can't you do this right? Get this together. Maybe you need to go back to that restrictive diet, right? That's the self-talk that's going through her day. And that self-talk basically was attached to any activity that she did. So Jessica thought that the problem that she had was, oh my gosh, I gained weight because I've been super permissive with eating. So she thought if she's being super permissive with eating, she needs to do a diet. But when we looked at what was actually happening, the problem was that she had no form in her day. Her morning started out with shitty self-talk, trying to calm her anxieties with consuming the media and just feeling shitty over and over and over again. So what we did was I helped her ask these questions to give her day some form. And then she started to pick out the things like, hey, if this is the ideal life that I want, and remember our lives are lived day to day. If this is the life that I want, here's how I need to live my life day to day. And these questions are going to help you start to create that day that you actually want. So I want to tell you what Jessica had to say. She said, I got my morning routine back, journaling, movement, gratitude. I felt great. I added fruit to my breakfast, added veggies to my lunches and dinners, no binging, no overeating. I do more reading versus scrolling. Jacqueline, I love everything about your coaching. You keep things simple. You make things feel doable. I love how you model behaviors. I would guess that you use a lot of the same tactics to teach adults as you did your elementary students. That's what adults need. Simple ways to build habits. Thank you. Okay. So Jessica just made a small shift. Okay. Remember that small habits, when repeated, actually lead to big changes. So what we did was we thought about how she wanted to feel. We thought about the activities that would help her feel that way. We thought about the thoughts. Like if she felt this way, what are the things that she would be saying to herself? And what are the things that she would be doing? Okay, so feelings, thoughts, actions. Okay, so instead of hopping out of her bed and immediately consuming social media, which made her feel gross, she hopped out of bed and was like, how do I want to feel? Ah, yes, I want to feel accomplished. I want to feel successful. I want to feel proud of myself. If that's how I want to feel, what do I need to do? Oh, I'm going to start my day with some morning movement. Oh, I'm going to start my day with some morning journaling, right? So that's how she started her day, with morning movement, morning journaling, adding fruits to her breakfast. And once she accomplished that in her morning, it was really easy to keep that up throughout her day. When her day started with her consuming a lot of social media, then she was turning to sugar and caffeine to kind of like soothe those emotions that social media and the world news kind of are making us feeling right now. So she shifted her morning. She shifted the rest of the things that happened. And yeah, she created the life that she wanted. Did she lose weight? Yeah, she lost weight because she's normal eating now. She's normal moving her body. She didn't have to do anything super restrictive or super over the top. We moved from this triangle that keeps happening to that other quadrant, which is authoritative, where we have boundaries in place to help ourselves feel good, not gross. So instead of those three questions that she had on repeat that were, what are you doing? What's wrong with you? Why can't you get anything together? We shifted the questions to these three questions, okay? How do I want to be feeling? It's my morning. How do I want to be feeling? Great. It's morning. How do I want to be feeling? Oh, I want to feel productive. I want to feel accomplished. I want to feel grateful. I want to feel good. Great. If that's how you want to be feeling, what are the thoughts that you might be having? I know for myself, it's like, oh, great. Great job, Jacqueline. You're doing a great job. It feels so good. This feels so good that you're moving your body. This feels so good that you're taking the pup for a walk. This feels so good. I'm so proud of you. Those are the thoughts that I have in my head when I feel accomplished, happy, successful. And then, so feelings, thoughts, what are you doing? What am I doing? What are the actions I'm doing? Okay, I'm taking the dog for a walk. I'm reading a book. I am journaling. I'm drinking water. Those are the things that I do that help me feel the way I want to feel. If I am doing the actions of checking social media first thing in the morning when I'm on the toilet, I feel gross right away. I feel gross. I feel disappointed in myself. Like, oh, shoot, like, why are you doing this thing again, right? So I'm going to do the things that are going to help me feel the way I want to feel during my day. Repeat that over and over and over and over again, and you get the life that you want. So it's not even just like, hey, we have to wait 10 years to create the life that we want, or even we don't have to wait until the pandemic is over. It's like, how can you create the life that you want during this time, during the pandemic, right? I know you don't want to be counting calories during the pandemic. I know you don't. I know you don't want to do a boot camp during the pandemic. You don't. That those things are not going to help you relieve stress, right? Those things are just going to make you more stressed out, right? So those three questions, I'm going to say them again. How do I want to be feeling? What are my thoughts? What am I doing? So you're at a fork in the road now, okay? It's been a couple of months, more than a couple of months, that we've been at home. Your day can continue to feel formless. You can continue to consume 2 hours of social media when you first wake up. You can continue to consume social media throughout the day and put on the television and then end the night with 4 hours of Netflix. You can continue this and feel kind of gross all day long and kind of have this formless day, or you can choose a different path. If you continue with your formless day, you are going to get the same outcomes over and over. And then chances are, like in my experience, in working with people, they get to this point where they feel really gross and they think, I got to do Whole30 again. I got to do Bright Lane eating again. I got to do keto again. No, if you put these boundaries up in place to help you feel good, not gross, day to day, you never have to do a restricted diet. A restrictive diet again. So if you want something different, you want to change the direction of your health, change the direction of your life, change the direction of the time that you're spending at home during the pandemic, you're going to have to do something different. So make a different choice, create a different life, use these three questions. How do I want to be feeling? What are my thoughts? And what am I doing? Okay. So a copy of this worksheet is in the links. You can download that. You can look at it. You can start writing that. Start creating the morning that you actually want. Start creating the day that you actually want. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Start creating the life that you actually want. Take care. I'll see you in the next one.